We want to graph the function that would give the slope of the tangent lines to the given function, graphed here in red. Well, the function that gives the slope of the tangent lines would be the derivative function. So we're given f of x, we want to graph f prime of x. So looking at the graph of f of x, let's first consider the graph on the interval from negative infinity to positive 2, where we have this sharp point in the graph. So again, we'll consider the function first on this interval here, where the interval is going to be open on 2, meaning it won't include 2, because notice how, because of this sharp point, we can't sketch a tangent line, and therefore the derivative function would be undefined. So again, we're considering this on the interval from negative infinity to positive 2, open on positive 2. Because the function is linear on this interval, notice if we select any point on the function in this interval, let's say this point here, the tangent line would contain this linear segment of the function. For example, here's the tangent line to the function at this point, and notice how it contains this function on this interval, which means we can use the slope of the function on this interval to determine the slope of the tangent line. So if we select two points on this interval, let's say this point here and this point here, we can use these two points to determine the slope of the function, which would also be the slope of the tangent line. Notice to go from this first point to the second point, we'd have to go down 1 unit, which means a change of y is negative 1, and then right 1 unit, which means a change of x is positive 1. Which means on this interval, the slopes of the tangent lines would be the change in y divided by the change of x, or negative 1 divided by 1, or negative 1. So now to graph the derivative function, which again will give the slope of the tangent lines, we'd have the constant function y equals negative 1 on the interval from negative infinity to 2, open on 2. So the graph would look something like this, where at 2 we have an open point because the derivative would be undefined. Now let's consider f of x on the interval from 2 to infinity, again open on 2. So we're considering the function on the interval from 2 to infinity. And again, notice how it is linear on this interval. So if we select any point on the function in this interval, let's say this point here, once again, the tangent lines are going to contain the function on this interval. So once again, we can use the slope of the function on this interval to determine the slopes of the tangent lines. So let's go ahead and select two points on this interval. Let's say this point here and this point here. Notice to go from the point on the left to the point on the right, we have to go up 2 units, so the change of y is positive 2, and then right 1 unit, so the change of x is positive 1. Which means the slopes of the tangent lines on this interval would be m equals the change of y divided by the change of x, or 2 divided by 1, which equals 2. So on the open interval from 2 to infinity, our derivative function would be the constant function y equals 2. Which means on this interval, the derivative function would look like this. An open point at x equals 2, and then to the right of 2, the constant function y equals 2. So again, for this piece of the function, the slopes of the tangent lines would be negative 1. And again, we cannot sketch a tangent line at x equals 2, so our derivative function is undefined at x equals 2. And then to the right of positive 2, or on the open interval from 2 to infinity, for this piece here, the slopes of the tangent lines would be positive 2. I hope you found this helpful.